Welcome to Let's Play ATV Off-Road Fury Part 3. So, let's move on to our next series. So, one thing I should mention first is that even though I have some profile points to spend on unlock things, I'm not gonna bother unlocking any of this shit until at, like, the end of the LP. Because I think there might be some stuff I can unlock naturally. I'm not sure. Probably not. But fuck it. Hey, Taman. Yeah, you made it. I might just completely ignore that rule later. I don't know. Depends on if I want another ATV. Anyways, for this segment, we're going to do the Pro National Series, which is a six-race series. And it's all pro and shit. Hooray. Hooray? Hooray. So, what ATV do I want to use this time? Let's see. Let's use one of my 20 Ravage Talons. How about that? Let's use a red one, because red suit. So, let's do that, and let's get going with race one. Alright, our first race takes us to White Sands Raceway. We actually have a starting gate this time. Ooh. Look at that shit. But I can just hold on to the gas, so it doesn't matter. Starting gate's there just purely for aesthetic. Bay. White Sands Raceway. This is a pretty cool track. It's like a supercross track, but in the national setting. Ooh. Oh, it's pretty cool. I like it. It's very white and sandy. I wonder why I got the name. Oh, it's pretty cool. So, yeah, different locations from the amateur nationals, because each track is a grouped into whatever amateur or pro series it's in. And it's pretty cool. Pretty nice. So we won't be repeating tracks until we get to, like, the expert stuff. But that won't be for a few segments. Also, I think this LP, although it's going to be longer as far as time, it's going to be shorter as far as number of segments than ATV Off-Road Fury 1. Because of how I'm formatting it, because A, Lamau, more content, which means longer, shorter videos. God damn it, GJ King. GG. It's so hilarious, I see you actually read the rules. Yes, he's being a meme head, of course he is. He's been here before, I know. Plus he just listed off, like, he intentionally broke just all the rules that are listed, so he's obviously a meme head. What is your favorite touring car series, like DTM and more? Fucking V8 Supercars? I consider them touring cars because of the way they are. And stuff. No hitting walls yet. No, but I have hit trees and a branch and... a fence. Another rider. You know, stuff. Yeah, what is rules? The dankest of memes. Also, I'm just kind of winning this race. Not really much happening. These jumps are too short to try any swanky tricks. Also, apparently I suck at preloading in this game. Hooray. The mitmays are real, yes. Nope, should have preloaded that. Damn it. Mayweather Killer's done. Time to be meme elsewhere. Oh, no you don't. No you don't, Whitworth. Go fuck yourself. So I think Whitworth is a chick. I saw a ponytail. And clearly dudes aren't allowed to have ponytails. Well, then again, in this game, you can't really customize how your rider looks, like, as far as outside of what they wear. So, you know. You know. What is a reading? Don't worry, Fab, I won't give you a shout-out, okay? Okay. Nope, I'm winning this race, fuck you. You're not clutching me. And we're gonna fly into the ocean. That's how we celebrate, by flying into the ocean and dying. Kappa. Nobody did any tricks in that race, I wonder why. Hmm. I don't know, but let's go to race 2, and, stuff. Alright, here we go for race 2 at Saguaro Wash. Or something like that. Hooray. And stuff. Anyways, just like with the Amateur Nationals, since I won the first race, all I have to do is finish this race to move on. Hooray. And I'm off to a great start by, sucking dick. In racing games, men don't have ponytails because they don't believe in Kyle Petty. What the fuck was that? No. Like Kyle Petty meme. That's the only thing I remember about Kyle Petty is just, it was what the fuck was that? Also Boogie Nights, ale him out. This track actually has big ramps. And weeds. Someone forgot to, get rid of the weeds on some parts of this track. Why did I do that? That was awful and bad idea. Rhino on a Monday, time to pretend I'm working. A Lamau. Hello, Crunch Biteness. Oh jeez. Oh jeez. Oh. I don't know how you survived that, Kinnaman, to be perfectly honest. Aw, damn it. I was about to, like, get all hype because, I first read Bednar's name as Bender, and I was gonna make an epic Futurama joke, but no, his name's Bednar. So, we're gonna hold this for maximum points. And go off the big ramp to do a one-footed Cordova and hold that for a million points, yay. I should really stop taking these turns so goddamn tight. Especially the ones with ramps right at the beginning. This is kind of fucking my momentum. Okay, let's go wide here. If I can do this. Do the quad! I did the quad. Halo now. Team at zero. Penis. Yeah, Bender made his own ATV off of Fury with Blackjack and Hooker, that's why he's not in this one. Meanwhile, Whitworth is just kind of way the fuck behind. Wonder what happened to her. No, you don't. Almost killed me. How many ATV games there are, dude. Shit's awesome. Rainbow Studios is awesome. I mean, granted, all for Fury 3 and 4 made by a different company, but still, MX vs. ATV series is really fucking cool. I don't know. It's a random type of racing because, you know, ATV racing is definitely a lot less popular than fucking motorcycle racing, but hey. Rainbow made it work, and it's fucking awesome. Oh, hey, Jesus. No, it's not Off-Road Fury 4, it's Off-Road Fury 2. Who the fuck is Rainbow Studios? The people that made first two ATV Off-Road Fury games, and also, the MX vs. ATV series? Yeah. Very excellent games. Oh god. Okay, we're good. Cordova. Yeah, ATV is like motorcycles cars combined. all the fun of motorcycle racing with the stability of having four wheels. It's twice as good, clearly. Yeah, holy crap, EW Alpha Fury, hey. I bet you guys weren't expecting me to stream this or LP this so soon. Halo now. I wonder if anybody got the hints that I posted on Twitter and Facebook. I'm guessing no. Since I played a song that's from this game, but... Also, apparently I think I have the audio low enough to where the music just can't be heard. Hooray! It's like it doesn't matter. I'm not giving you the authentic HVR for Fury 2 experience with the music low like this. Nothing! Doing nothing. Yeah, I just said that, Crunchbite. ATV, or MX vs. ATV series is made by the same people who made the first two ATV Off-Road Fury series, aka Rainbow Studios. And stuff. Also, I'm just kind of dominating this race. I have a fucking estimated 5-second lead. Because it's just like Need for Speed Underground, where the gaps are estimated times, not actual, like, definitive gaps based on, you know... they're estimated gaps based on, like, distance and speed and stuff. What you doing? Nothing. Hooray, I won. Very dominating fashion. Wee! Perfect way to end that. That was great. No, that's fine, Crunchbite. Hey, I scored the most, stunt points. Ooh. Okay, well... I have one race lead already, so let's go to race 3. Alright, here we are at Anaconda Run for race number 3 of the Professional National Series. So, off we go for that. I heard crashing. I heard grunting, which means crashing. Yeah, Bednar is RIP. Okay. Oh, you used to live in Australia, Crunchbite? That's cool. Climax is fucking based. I don't even remember, like, all the games that they've made. I just know Off-Road Fury 3 and 4. To be honest. Excuse me, sir. Oh no, don't. Okay, he didn't land on me. Good. Look at Mr. fucking Swag Preload Man over here. Doing a bunch of swag preloads. Let's go around the outside for maximum momentum. Probably should have done a trick there. Oh well. And then I decided to do a trick on a very bad, bad jump. I'm the greatest, let me tell you. Oh, shnikes, what am I doing? We're good, everything's fine. I'm only in third place, we're doing good. Bednar's recovered to fourth thanks to rubber banding. Good for him. I can hear very, very faint vocals in the background, because music in-game. Disco. Fucking just preload over uphill whoops, because fuck that shit. My trick was better than yours. Excuse me. Oh, Jesus. Well, that was a bad jump. Okay, let's just make it up here. Don't try to do a stupid trick. Ugh, fuck. Okay, two laps down. Oh, Kenman, I think, was bicycling a little bit there, and he just... Okay. Oh, no! Just a wall tap. Just a wall tap. You know. Of course the stream is a sausage fest. I'm playing a fucking... video game that isn't League of Legends or Hearthstone. Of course it's a sausage fest. Hey, LaMau. So Climax made a bunch of Nickelodeon games. Shovelware? And also Serious Sam Next Encounter, really? Whee! Yeah, this game's pretty good. Like, I kinda wanna, like, retract what I said about the original Alpha of Fury at the end of that LP. Cause the game's good, it's just that there's not a lot of shit to do in the game. I mean, you saw how quickly I breezed through it. There's just not really much to do. It's fucking two championships and you can do single enduro races and stuff. This game is just, it's like that game except it has a shit ton more content, and also, you know, actually makes freestyle have some kind of importance other than just being there. Excuse me, Bednar. I know you're going for the epic comeback, but fuck off. Alpha Fury 1 is just a typical, like, first game in the series where there isn't a whole lot of... Like, there's a lot of ideas, just not a lot of And then this game is just like, alright, we have a foundation, let's fucking make this shit awesome. And awesome they made it. No, fuck. Damn it, didn't have enough speed. My ATV is not fast enough. This Ravage talent sucks. No wonder you get it from the tutorial, it sucks ass. Kappa. It's the final lap. Oh shit. I fucked that up. Royally. Excuse me, pardon me. Time for backflip, except you can't do that in this game. Backflips weren't the norm for fucking freestyle in 2002, so, this game is identical to MX Unleashed because it's made by the same company. Once Rainbow Studios lost the rights to, ATV Offroad Fury, they made the MX Unleashed series, or MX vs. ATV series. With the same general, foundation of, you know, first two Off-Road Fury games. Cause yeah. GT became good in GT4. How's it feel to be wrong, Barna? Like, GT1 was excellent, GT2 was outright amazing. GT3 was an awesome early PS2 title with not a lot of content compared to GT2. And then GT4 is just like, holy fuck, this is amazing. And there we go, I win. I win, therefore I must crash into something. Or do a victory wheelie or something. Hooray. Also got the most stunt points again, swag. And an 11-point lead over Kinnaman after three races, so... Let's move on to the second half of the championship. Here we are. Had a race for Palisades Cross something. I don't fucking know. It's a track. Oh. I think I might remember this track, actually. Also, we're going this way. If this is the yep, this is definitely the track I'm thinking about. This is a very long track with a lot of big jumps. A lot of big jumps. Hello, Arn. Once again, Barna, you know not what you're saying. GT2 is just like... Well, I just killed Whitworth, whoops. But, GT2 is like GT2 is GT1, is like this game, Stage of Fury 1. They had a foundation, and they just fucking went over, and they put a bunch of shit in it, and it's awesome. Oh, balls, what am I doing? Okay, I was expecting a bounce off of that, but I didn't get a bounce. Look at that map size. Yeah, it's kind of big. This is kind of a long-ass track. Also, there's a spam bot in test chat. If someone could, like, get rid of that, that'd be awesome. Yep, this is exactly the place I was thinking of. Because I remember that fucking, bridge. Just all these long straights with the epic jumps. And the ability to do 10 trillion tricks. Oh, GT2's car list was amazing, especially with all the race mods. Like, that's what makes me love GT2's car list so much, is just all the race mods and the obscure cars, like the fucking E-Space F1, or S-Space F1, and the GT90, and I just crashed. Whoops. Whoopsie. That's one reason why I really want to get an X-Bone and play Forza 6, because the car list in that looks fucking incredible. Like, there's a lot of cars throughout the history of cars, and it's really fucking cool. GT1's physics weren't weird. At least I don't think so. Tsunami! Oh, well, there goes Whitworth and Bednar. Give me the lead. Okay, lap one complete. 2.5 minutes. Hooray. Hooray! Yeah, there's a Venturi Atlantique in Test Drive 6. I don't know that. Carlos Forza 6 is amazing. Like, the only thing that kind of irks me about the Carlos and Forza 6 is the fact that there's 10 different Formula E's, and they're all listed as different cars instead of just different livery. But I can't really complain, because GT5 and 6 and fucking, yeah, with the 10 trillion Skylines and 10 billion MX5s, you know. This is gonna hurt, yep. Bad idea. Whee! Suicide no-hander. Oh jeez, I shouldn't have done that. Went for the triple. I had the fucking limo in Forza 6. That shit's awesome. I watched Testra's video of him trying to win a game of tag in that fucking thing, and almost winning. He got on the podium. You see, I don't understand the compressed endurance idea for GT6, to be honest. Like, sure, I know the game is definitely pandered more towards casual crowd, which is why the rubber banding is so fierce and, yeah. Oh, okay, Whitworth got lucky there. That didn't land on her face. Shit. But, yeah, they could have at least, like, had an option to scale down the Enduros or something, I don't know. That's like one of the things that is always like never thought of. Like, oh hey, we have these endurance races. Well, I guess if the person doesn't really want to do all this, we can at least scale down the length for them. Or they have the option to scale down the length. It's just that, you know, they don't get as much prize. I think that would be perfect in every game like Forza or GT. Every game that has an endurance race. Like, well, this is beautiful. Just everyone dies here. Look at, Toka Race Driver 3. All the championships in that game can scale it from either one lap to, like, a maximum length, like, you know, 2-hour race or whatever. Or what would be realistic for that series in real life. How does scaling sound like a bad idea? It isn't. Hey, Fralligator. Excuse me, Bednar. Rip Bednar. Rippin' pepperoni. Forza 1, 2, and I think 3 have Enduros, and then 6 has Enduros. 6 has actual endurance races because 300 miles, yo. Yeah, like scaling in NASCAR games. It's like you choose to do fucking all 500 miles, or you choose to do like 15 miles. You know, why do I keep fucking doing this turn all kinds of wrong? We're not gonna try to do a trick, because uphill. Hello, Whitworth. Man, I'm really spaghettiing these preloads, like all of them. I'm not getting the full preload. Ever. Hit him straight in the noggin with the fucking ATV, oh yeah. Build up some speed. Go off the jump. And I'm gonna take the wide path here. Turn 10 strongly hitting at NASCAR returning. Why? What are they doing? I haven't been following anything like Turn 10's been doing. Oh, shit. Oh, pfft. I'll rip those two. Hit them right on the head, mate. Hello, electrical base here. Daytona and V8 engine swaps. It's not really hinting, it's just like, hey, let's have this in the game, because why not? Yeah, no, it sucks that Polyphony broke tradition by fucking removing endurance races from GT6, and also no 300k at Grand Valley. Oh well, let's just hope they redeem themselves with fucking GT7. By redeem themselves, I mean put the fucking endurances back. No one has dicked the spam bot yet, because it's fucking... My mods aren't in Titch... Oh, hacked. And as soon as that happens, or as soon as you mention that... Yeah, that final straight is just a fucking spaghetti fest. With everyone, including myself. Let's take a tight turn again, so I have no momentum over the jump. Sounds good, right? Rip Whitworth. Okay, I need to stop doing one-footed Cordova. I'm getting fucking basic trick points out of it now. Oh, jeez. Oh, they shared juniors. Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, I guess that might be a hint for NASCAR Dilk. I know Dale Jr. has the whole Xbox One Halo 5 livery thing coming up or whatever. I want the fucking Bathurst 1000 GT7. That would make me cum everywhere. Oh, how the fuck did you die approaching the ramp? Also, I'm doing another Cordova. God damn it. I need to press another direction when I'm pressing L1 square, or not square, it's a triangle and circle. I probably should have preloaded that. Yep. Missed the triple. I missed the triple. Oh, it was yesterday. Oh. Fucking. I'm not paying attention. I don't pay attention to fucking NASCAR shit. Because, yeah. Because I'm way behind on. I don't keep with the times, man, because I suck ass. Use saran wrap? I don't think the saran wrap is a move in this game. There's a scorpion. You can do that. McMurray also had a Halo 5 livery? Really? No, Miller. GT7. Vitz Race. 10 laps. Route X. Holy shit. Capoli shit. Oh god. Okay, we're about halfway through the lap, which means I still have a chance of winning. Plus the whole final straightaway is just, like said, spaghetti fest. Oh jeez. Preload, get the triple! Got it. 10 laps route X is Citroen 2CV. No. That'd be a 24-hour race in itself. Actually, that'd be longer than 24 hours. Oh! Rip Kinnaman. Why did I preload? I'm just gonna go to the small ramps. Seems like a better idea. I don't know why it seemed like a better idea, but it just did to me. Uh-oh, Ludo's gonna go eat bitches. Uh-oh. Okay, now. Preload. There goes one. Can I get the other one? Nope. Win streak is over. I finally lost a race, god damn it. That took a long time to actually lose a race, considering how clutch some of these wins were. So there's race 4. I still have a 15-point lead, so let's move on to race number 5. Alright, here we go. Race 6 at a track I didn't read the name of because I was too busy looking at Twitter, because I'm professional. So, this is going to be another lengthy one, it looks like. But this one's more congested than the, well, actually, no. It's just more of a, I guess they're both intestine. I don't fucking know. Shut up, me. Point is, going to be another, 10-minute race. Yes, I'm very raged. No, I'm not. I don't give a shit that I finished second. I don't have to win every race. Let's start by doing a one-footed Cordova for first time of about 2 million. Newcastle Landing is this track? Ew, okay. Hooray, someone read the menu while I didn't. Rhino rage. How's that for an old meme? Disco. Oh shit. Got a little bouncy there. I couldn't steer my quad on that landing. Oh no. Okay, we're good. The banking was friendly to me. Excuse me, pardon me. Still taking shitty lines. This game's fucking awesome. Also, hello, Anderson. Okay, I guess I should've tripled that. I definitely should've tripled that. Fuck, I do my- oh shit. I hit the starting gate place. Whoops. Yeah, make my viewers do the work for me. I'm actually not playing this game right now, someone else is. I'm actually making Thunder play the game. Let's keep making tight turns because it works. No, it doesn't. Holy man! Excuse me. Oh, I see what's happening. These guys are changing their gear mid-race, or mid-championship. I thought the option was only for me. What the fuck, game? I don't know. You saw two Lambos the other day? Fuck you, Seaford. Owned. Okay. I'm in last place. Let's do something about that. Whitworth is way the fuck ahead. She won't be for long. Because rubber banding is a thing. Yes, I adopted a 10-year-old Chinese kid to play the games for me. When does Thunder start stream? After I finish my stream. That's how he's been doing it. My god, I really should stop trying to take tight turns in these sandy areas. Because no grip. Oh, fuck. Yeah, I'm still in Pro Nationals. Series because it's kind of long. Because these tracks are very long. By these tracks, I mean two of them. Well, this one isn't as long as the last one, but still... fuck. Well, I got my, body, my spine rearranged. Oh shit. Okay, we're good. Pretty much, Barna. Oh jeez, okay. And also so people will actually like watch his stream, because people who usually watch Thunder streams are people who watch my streams! And he doesn't want to be like, well... still gonna watch Rhino, because then we can... I don't know. Yearly GTs, the series would probably be a lot worse, Seaferg, if Polyphony made yearly GT games. Not gonna lie. I mean, Forza's been doing, I have to give Turn 10 credit, they've been doing really good having a 2-year release schedule for Forza, considering the only really, like, bad game in the series was 5. But yeah. Oh fuck! Well, rip top 3. Everyone's dead. I'm gonna not preload this time. Just take it low. GT5 wasn't even that bad. It just had a couple shitty things about it, but it wasn't really that bad. I mean, it wasn't as good as the 5-year delay should have made it, but you know. God, the sandy sections! So much sand. So much not grip. Holy Man, aka the Crucifixion, yeah. Too bad the Kiss of Death isn't in this game, because they fucking censor it and just call it the COD. And, games that have the Kiss of Death. Honestly, B-Spec isn't even that bad. The AI sucks, but B-Spec isn't that bad as in itself. Like, the only things I really don't like about GT3 are the AI in B-Spec being fucking pussies and not wanting to overtake when they clearly can. And, the really bad XP system. It's just not good. And the fact that the Formula GT is is like the rarest car in the game, and it's required to beat the game. Excuse me. Now, I'm not saying GT5 is great. I mean, even though I say GT5 is good, I was still disappointed in it because it wasn't as good as I'd hoped it'd be, especially after 4. But yeah. I know, Q, shut up. I'll give you nothing. I don't know. Hey, yeah, Bush. And GT6 was, you know, way too short, way too easy. No enduros. Handled good, but yeah. Oh, shnikes. Forgot to preload and triple this, goddammit. Oh, hey, I won. That was the last lap. Great! Wasn't even paying attention to what lap it was, okay. Get fucked, nerds. Well, I won the championship. 21-point lead. Hooray. So, yeah. To the final race of this Pro National Series. Alright, here we are at Hawthorne Mills for our final race. Look, logs! It's a lumber place. Alright, here we go. For final race of the Pro National Series. Sixth and final race. And stuff. So one thing I should probably note, since I'm not showing the loading screens, is that, the point requirements, once you reach the final race, there are no point requirements, because there's no race after this, so yeah, it just says point requirements or place requirement is not available. Still has a line though, under fifth place, so yeah, I guess they just didn't bother removing it for the final race. Also, what is this? Everyone's fucking this section up, holy shit. Damn it. And probably should have preloaded to do the quad. Just kind of feeling my way out because I don't remember these tracks that well because it's been a while since I played this game. Last. So yeah. So yeah. Feeling it out. Yeah. Oh, hello. The Escudo is the only car in GT2. Everyone shits about the Escudo in GT2 just like everyone shits about the GTO in GT1 for Mega Speed Cup. Like, wow, why aren't you using the GTO? Like, because I'm allowed to use other cars? But you have to use the GTO, it's the fastest car, it has the highest horsepower rating. But I don't want to use the GTO. Use it, you fuck! You're not playing the game right if you don't use it. Etc. Also, it's okay, I took Meshkin with me. We're good. Everything's fine. It's okay, Miller. I'm not judging you for using the GT. I'm just saying other people. I've literally seen videos where someone's like, why didn't you... You're supposed to use the GTO because it's the highest horsepower, etc. The scooter doesn't fucking matter after GT2. They, you know, made it, like, poopy in GT3, which they should have, because it's fucking for fucking hill climbs, not actual racing. God, the Cultus Pike Speed car. The other Suzuki. Nice solid fourth place. I was about to say third, but no. Bednar had passed me. Fucking asshole. Polyphony, why don't you hire me? Aren't they accepting, like, positions for shit for GT7 development? Weird. GT3 records sight and lives with the entire top 10 uses a Scudo for Sunday Cup. It's because of Super Speedway. I suck ass. I thought they said they were hiring people. Need the facts of my resume. Stat, yeah. Hearing a Need for Speed 3-like song? I don't fucking know. I can't even hear the music. All I hear is the whining of the engines. Or the growling, I guess. Not really whining. That's not English. Turn 10's hiring as well? Hmm. Interesting. Oh. You got lucky there, Kinnaman. We're riding over that fucking block. Okay, I'm just gonna double. Almost double. And then single. And go tight line here. Herpity derp derp. And die. I use test track so much instead of super speed. I don't know. They wanted to show off their newly redesigned test track. That's why. It's like, ooh, look, the test drive's a lot. Test track's a lot longer now. Ooh. Excuse me, Whitworth. What song is even playing? 8-cylinder jam. Not sure who that's by, but hey. Also, pause menu, options, yay. Anyways. You know what I just realized I never did? I didn't cycle through the cameras. Here's Chase camera 2. Oh, Polyphony hired turn 10 people. Oh. Well, I know they hired the one sound guy from turn 10. I was like, they hired anybody else, unless I'm mistaken. Which I probably am, considering how dumb I am. And out of, like, the loop I am. Then we have the slot cam, which is really disorienting for me. This is a beautiful camera right here. Perfect. My immersion is 100% right now. Classic cam, then first person view, which is really nice actually. I like this. A lot better than the, and it does that when you do a trick. Oh, shit. I might have to use the first-person camera for some races, because if a game has a good first-person camera, I like to use it along with the chase cam in my LP, so I might start using that in some races. I just remember that I forgot to cycle through the camera, so I'm just like, I should have tripled, or tried to triple. A new test track of GT7 makes Route X look like Martinsville. It's totally gonna happen. Must catch Meshkin while trying to pass Kinnaman. So far, neither of these things are happening. It's how rough the terrain is. And how shitty I am at going fucking around it. Or over it. Gonna be using first person while in Forza. Oh yeah, in-car cameras are fucking awesome. It's like what I did in GT5. Use the in-car camera when I could. Not alt like for every race, but yeah. I'll do something like I did in GT5 where I'll do some races with Chase Cameron, some races with in-car. I'm going the right path, because fuck this jump. I don't like the jump, just fuck it. Okay. Final lap of the Professional National Series. After another lengthy race, over 9 minutes now. I'm not gonna make it. Okay, I just barely made the top of it. Get the triple, yeah. Okay, now, just gonna double. Double. There we go, that's how I wanted to do that, and then I'm fucked here, because I went the slow lane. Although I got a nice boost from Meshkin there. She wants the D, clearly. I don't know what I'm saying. What a soothing engine sound, I know, right? Oh god, that's bad, that's very bad. Down the hill! Oh, hey Russian Dan. Unless you're a different Russian person. I don't even fucking know. Hello, Emily. Tsunami! I haven't really done a lot of tricks in this race. Whoops. Okay, you can do your epic ramp jump. I'm just gonna go this way. Females don't watch me. They don't exist on the internet. Clutch win? Clutch win. Suck it. Aw, yeah. And my best lap of the race at the end there. That was nice. I got the least amount of stunt points. Hooray. Wow. It's okay, I won by fucking 26 points. I can see these championships are probably going to be easy to win just because of how, everybody finishes in different places. Fucking, I don't know. Alright, here's our gold trophy for the Pro Nationals. We got 1,000 profile points, A. Nice. So there's our trophy case, aw yeah. Just press circle this time to return to the championship select screen, there we go. So, upon getting the gold trophy, we unlock the expert Pro Nationals, which we'll do after I finish all the normal stuff. So, there we go. Second championship's down. And with that, stay tuned for more HVR Offroad Fury 2.